Today, myself Rajeshwari. Today we will discuss about pneumococci. So under this we'll study about morphology, culture, biochemical reactions, resistance, antigenic structure, variation, toxin and other virulence factors, pathogenesis, epidemiology, laboratory diagnosis, treatment and prophylaxis. So let's begin. Pneumococci are the normal commensals of the upper respiratory tract. They are important pathogens of pneumonia and otitis media in children. They are reclassified as Streptococcus pneumonia because of its genetic relatedness to Streptococcus. They differ from Streptococci in their morphology, bile solubility, octochin sensitivity and by a specific polysaccharide capsule. Now let's know about the pneumococcus morphology. Pneumococcus, either otherwise known as pneumococci, are gram positive, small, that means 1 micrometer diameter, slightly elongated cocci arranged in pairs with broad ends in opposition. Each coccus has one end broad or rounded and other pointed, flame-shaped or lanceolate appearance. They are capsulated and capsule encloses each pair. The capsule may be demonstrated each pair. The capsule may be demonstrated as a clear hollow in India ink preparation. The old cultures, the capsule is usually lost. They are non-motile and non-sporing. Now let's know about the culture. Pneumococci have complex nutritional requirements and therefore grow only in enriched media, especially supplemented with blood. They are aerobes and facultative are anaerobes and their growth is approved by 5 to 10% carbon dioxide. The optimum temperature for growth is 37 degrees centigrade and pH 7.8. On blood agar, after incubation for 18 hours, the colonies are usually small, that means 0.5 to 1 mm, dome-shaped, with an era of greenish discoloration around them. On prolonged incubation, the colonies become flat with raised edge and central umbonation, which creates a draughtsman's appearance. Some strains, such as those of serotype 3 and 7, from large mucoid colonies due to production of abundant capsular polysaccharides. Pneumococci are typical alpha hemolytic, but under anaerobic conditions, colonies show beta hemolysis due to liberation of oxygen label pneumolysin O by this bacteria. In liquid medium such as glucose broth, pneumococci produce uniform turbidity. These cocci readily undergo autolysis in cultures due to the action of intracellular enzymes. Autolysis is enhanced by bile salts and other surface active agents. This property is helpful to differentiate it from other streptococci. Now let's know about biochemical reactions. Pneumococci ferment several sugars with production of acid only. Fermentation is tested in his serum water. Fermentation of inulin by pneumococci is of great value to differentiate them from streptococci. Pneumococci are soluble in bile when 2% sodium deoxycholate solution is added to a broth culture in natural pH, the culture clears due to the lysis of the cocci. Alternatively, if a loop full of 10% sodium colate solution is placed on a pneumococcus colony, lysis of colony occurs within a few minutes. Bile solubility test is an important diagnostic test to differentiate pneumococcus from other streptococci. This test is based on the presence of an autolytic enzyme amidase in the pneumococci. This enzyme cleaves the bond between the alanine and muriatic acid in the peptidoglycan. The amidase is activated by bile salts, resulting in lysis of the bacteria. Now come to pneumococci are catalyzed and oxidase negative. Now come to resistant. Pneumococci are delicate organisms and are destroyed at 52 degree centigrade for 15 minutes. They are more sensitive to usual antiseptics. They are sensitive to a wide range of antibiotics including penicillins, erythromycin, tetracycline, chloramphenicol, vancomycin and clindamycin. Penicillin resistant strains first appeared in 1967. It may be due to mutation or gene transfer. The drug resistant to penicillin is not due to production of beta lactamase, but alteration in the penicillin binding proteins on the bacterial surface. These strains are also resistant to multiple drugs. Pneumococci are sensitive to optocin in a concentration of 1/5 lakh. When a 6 mm optocin disc is applied on a blood agar plate inoculated with pneumococci, a wide zone of inhibition occurs in incubation. This is very useful test to differentiate pneumococci from other streptococci which do not show zone of inhibition by optocin disc. Now come to antigenic structure. The most important antigen of the pneumococcus is capsular polysaccharide. Other antigens are somatic M protein and A group specific cell wall carbohydrates. Now come to capsular polysaccharides. Capsular polysaccharide is type specific. Since this polysaccharide is soluble in tissue and culture fluid, it diffuses into the culture medium or tissues and infective exudates. Hence, it is also called the soluble specific substance. In short, SSS. Pneumococci are classified into types based on the nature of the capsular polysaccharides. More than 90 serotypes are recognized. There are named 1, 2, 3 and so on. Serological typing of pneumococcus is carried out by three methods. First is agglutination of microorganisms with type-specific antiserum. Next is precipitation of capsular polysaccharide with type specific antiserum. Third point is Quelung reaction or capsule swelling reaction was described by scientist named Newfield in 1902. In this reaction, a suspension of pneumococci is mixed on a slide with a drop of specific antiserum and a loop full of methylene blue solution. In presence of the homologous antiserum, the capsule around pneumococci reveals an apparent swelling, sharply delineated and refractile under the microscope. The Quelung test can be done either in sputum or in culture and used to be a routine bedside procedure in old days. Now come to M protein. M protein is characterized for each type of pneumococcus. It is not associated with virulence and antibody to M protein is non-protective. Now come to cell wall carbohydrate, C substances. Pneumococci contain a specific specific carbohydrate antigen which is named as C substance. It is present in all pneumococci. The C substance is precipitated by an abnormal protein that appears in the acute phase sera of cases of pneumonia but disappears during convalescence. It is also detected in blood of patients with some other illnesses. This is known as the C reactive protein, insert CRP. It is not an antibody of C substances. It is an acute phase substance produced in hepatocytes. Its production is stimulated by bacterial infections, malignancies, and tissue destruction. CRP is used as an index of activity in rheumatic fever and certain other conditions. CRP is routinely detected in serum by lactase agglutination test. Variation. Let's know about the variation. Variation. Pneumococci is virulent in capsulated form but non-capsulated, that means rough forms are avirulent. On repeated subculture, a smooth to rough variations occur. R forms arises as spontaneous mutants and outgrowth the parenteral S forms in artificial culture. Such R mutants are eliminated in tissues by phagocytosis. Rough pneumococci of one serotype may be made to produce capsules of the same or different serotypes on treatment with DNA from the respective serotypes of pneumococci. This transformation was discovered by Griffith in 1928 as the first instance of genetic exchange of information in bacteria. Now come to toxins and other virulence factors. Pneumococci produce an oxygen label intracellular hemolysin and a leukocidin. The virulence of pneumococci is dependent upon its capsule, which prevents or inhibits phagocytosis. Non-capsulated strains are avirulent. The antibody to the capsular polysaccharide protects against infection. Due to the abundance of capsular material, the virulence of type 3 pneumococcus is enhanced. Pneumolysin, a toxin produced by pneumococci, is another virulence factor. It has cytotoxic and complement activating properties. It is immunogenic. Now come to pathogenesis. Streptococci pneumonia is one of the most common bacteria causing pneumonia, both lobar and bronchopneumonia. It is also responsible for acute tracheobronchitis and emphysema. Lobar pneumonia. Let's know about lobar pneumonia. Pneumonia results only when the general resistance is lowered. Common infective types of streptococcal pneumonia include types 1 to 12 in adults and types 6, 4, 14, 19 and 23 are responsible in children. Now come to bronchopneumonia. It is almost always a secondary infection following viral infections of the respiratory tract. Any serotype of pneumococcus can produce bronchopneumonia. Other causative agents responsible for bronchopneumonia include Staphylococcus aureus, K pneumonia, Streptococcus pyogenes, H. influenzae, Fusobacterium species and bacteroids. Now come to meningitis. It is the most serious of pneumococcal infections. Streptococcal pneumonia is the second most important cause of pyogenic meningitis after N. meningitis. The pneumococcus spreads from the pharynx to the meninges via bloodstream. Other bacterial agents of pyogenic meningitis include N. meningitis, एच इन्फ्लुएंजा, स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल अगलाक्टी दैट इज ग्रुप बी एंड लिस्टेरिया मोनोसाइटोजेंस. नाउ लेट्स नो अबाउट द अदर इन्फेक्शंस. निमोकोकस में ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस एम्पीमा, पेरिकार्डिटिस, ओटिटिस मीडिया, साइनोसाइटिस, कंजक्टिविटिस, पेरिटोनिटिस एंड सुपरेटिव आर्थ्राइटिस यूजुअली एज कॉम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ निमोनिया. नाउ कम टू एपिडेमियोलॉजी. द सोर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन इन्फेक्शन इज कैरियर एंड लेस ऑफन पेशेंट. निमोकोकी आर ट्रांसमिटेड बाई इनहेलेशन ऑफ कंटेमिनेटेड डस्ट ड्रॉपलेट्स और ड्रॉपलेट न्यूक्लियाई. इन्फेक्शन यूजुअली लीड्स टू फैरिंजियल कैरियस. डिजीज रिजल्ट्स ओनली व्हेन द होस्ट रेजिस्टेंस इज लोयर्ड बाय फैक्टर्स सच एज रेस्पिरेटरी वायरल इन्फेक्शंस, माल न्यूट्रिशन एसेट्रा. लोबर निमोनिया इज यूजुअली ए स्पोराडिक डिजीज बट एपिडेमिक्स में अकर. द इंसिडेंस ऑफ ब्रोंको निमोनिया इज मोर व्हेन एन एपिडेमिक ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंजा और अदर वायरल इन्फेक्शंस ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट अकर्स. नाउ कम टू लैबोरेटरी डायग्नोसिस. स्पेसिमेंस क्लिनिकल सैंपल्स सच एज स्पर्टम, सेरिब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड इंसर्ट CSF, प्लूरल एक्सुडेट और ब्लड आर कलेक्टेड अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइट ऑफ लेसन. ब्लड कल्चर इज यूजफुल इन निमोकोकल सेप्टिसेमिया. नाउ कम टू कलेक्शन एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट. ऑल द स्पेसिमेंस शुड बी कलेक्टेड इन स्टेराइल कंटेनर्स अंडर ऑल एसेप्टिक कंडीशंस. दे शुड बी प्रोसेस्ड इमीडिएटली. इन केस ऑफ डिले CSF स्पेसिमेन शुड नेवर बी रेफ्रिजरेटेड बट केप्ट एट 37 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. अनदर कॉजेटिव एजेंट ऑफ पायोजेनिक मेनिंजाइटिस मे डाई एट कोल्ड टेम्परेचर. नाउ कम टू डायरेक्ट माइक्रोस्कोपी एंड एंटीजन डिटेक्शन. ग्राम स्टेनिंग ऑफ स्मीयर रिवेल्स ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पॉलीमर्स एंड टिपिकल ऑर्गेनिज्म. इन केस ऑफ मेनिंजाइटिस प्रिजम्प्टिव डायग्नोसिस मे बी मेड बाय फाइंडिंग ग्राम पॉजिटिव डिप्लोकोकी विच मे बी इंट्रासेलुलर एज वेल एज एक्स्ट्रासेलुलर इन CSF स्मीयर. कैप्सूल स्वेलिंग मे बी ऑब्जर्व अंडर माइक्रोस्कोप और निमोकोकी आर मिक्सड विथ टाइप स्पेसिफिक एंटीसेरा. कैप्सुलर पॉलीसैकेराइड एंटीजन कैन बी डेमोन्स्ट्रेटेड बाय काउंटर इम्यूनो इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस. This has been employed in blood, urine and cerebrospinal fluid. Antigen may also be detected by latex agglutination or coagulation. Now come to culture. Specimen is inoculated on blood agar and incubated at 37 degree centigrade for 24 hours in the presence of 5-10% carbon dioxide. Typical colonies develop with alpha hemolysis. Organism from the isolated colony are identified by gram staining and biochemical reaction. Now come to colony morphology and staining. Colony are usually small, that means 0.5 to 1 mm with alpha hemolysis around them. On prolonged incubation, colonies have dwarfness appearance. On gram staining, pneumococci are gram positive, small, the 1 micrometer diameter diplococci, they are flame shaped or lanceolate in appearance. The capsule may be demonstrated as a clear hollow in India ink preparation. Now come to biochemical reactions. Important biochemical tests are inulin fermentation and bile solubility test. Another test which has a great value to octocin sensitivity test. Now come to animal pathogenicity test. From specimens where organisms are expected to be scanty, intraperitoneal inoculation in mice may be used. Inoculated mice die in 24-48 hours. Heart blood and peritoneal exudate of the animal shows pneumococci. The taste may be negative with occasional strains, which are virulent for mice. Type 14 strains. Now come to antibiotic sensitivity test. It is especially useful in strains which are resistant. Now come to care treatment. The antibiotic of choice is parenteral penicillin. Cephalosporin is indicated in case of penicillin resistant strains. Now come to prophylaxis. Immunity is type specific and is associated with antibody to the capsular polysaccharide. The existence of more than 90 serotype makes makes prophylactic immunization impracticable, but as a limited number of serotypes cause most of the pneumonia cases, vaccination is possible. The polysaccharide vaccine containing prevalent serotypes is administered by a single dose injection. Such vaccines are used only in those persons who are at enhanced risk of pneumococcal infection. These include persons with absent or dysfunctional spleen, nephrotic syndrome, sickle cell anemia, multiple myeloma, hepatic cirrhosis, diabetes mellitus, and immunodeficiencies including HIV infection. Vaccination is contraindicated in lymphomas. Finally finished. Any questions regarding this, you can ask me in the comment box, and subscribe my channel to know more topics on biotechnology. Thank you. जय जगन्नाथ.